Did you know there are whales that can dive down to the Titanic? Okay, it's a slight exaggeration, but not by much. The Titanic lies at about 12,500 feet below the surface of the ocean. Cuvier's beaked whales have actually come close to that. They've been recorded reaching depths of over 10,000 feet. And they did it by holding their breath for over 3 hours. Take a moment to process this. Only a handful of people have seen the abyssal plane, and these marine mammals do it on the reg. This is a routine trip to the grocery store for them. Let's talk about how. How marine mammals can survive these types of depths. Well, they have a lot of really unique adaptations. For one, the resting position of their nostrils is closed. As you can see here in this video of one of my walruses. The same is true for a whale's blowhole. They have to actually flex it in order to take a breath. This is simply to prevent water from getting into their lungs. Most deep diving marine mammals also don't have external ear flaps. A lot of people have commented on my walrus videos, "Hey, where are their ears?" And they don't have external ears like we do. Neither do whales. So you see this little bump right behind their eye? That is actually a vestigial ear, and it doesn't really lead to an ear canal. But that doesn't really explain how they can survive the extreme pressure of the deep water. At just 200 meters under the water, or 650 feet, the pressure would pop a champagne cork into the bottle. That's not even as deep as the current No Limits world record holding free dive. Herbert Nitsch, who held his breath for 4 minutes and dove to a depth of 214 meters, or a little over 700 feet. That is wild. I can get to about 30 before I start to freak out. Herbert Nitsch required extensive rehab just so that he could walk again. Let's go a little deeper. Like halfway down to the Titanic deep, at around 6,200 feet or 1,900 meters, if you punctured a scuba tank, water would rush in instead of air rushing out. That's how deep sperm whales and elephant seals dive. Elephant seals, sperm whales, and Cuvier's beaked whales actually breathe out before their dives so that their lungs are empty. And their ribs are loosely articulated and jointed so that they actually do collapse under the immense pressure of the deep ocean. They, for lack of a better word, self-implode as they dive down. So I talked a bit about Herbert Nitsch, the human who currently holds the No Limits freediving record, and the toll his dives took on his body. But what about marine mammals? Do these dives have any sort of adverse effects on them? The answer is yes, it does. Necropsies on Cuvier's beaked whales and sperm whales have found stress fractures in their bones and their teeth, which kind of gives me the heebie-jeebies just to think about. They can also suffer from decompression sickness, just like humans. To prevent this from happening, marine mammals will limit how fast they return to the surface, just like a human would on taking a dive. All this is to say that unlike humans, these marine mammals are almost perfectly evolved to dive to extreme depths, and they do it for a very good reason: food. These dives aren't recreational trips for marine mammals. They're not tourist sightseeing. We believe sperm whales and Cuvier's beaked whales dive to extreme depths to feed on giant squid and octopus. I say we believe again because we only have circumstantial evidence to support this. It's actually never been documented. All we know about the feeding behavior of Cuvier's beaked whales is from stomach analysis, and it looks like cephalopods make up about 98% of their diet. There is some evidence that Cuvier's beaked whales make highly coordinated foraging dives in small social groups. But the truth is, we don't really know. And that's the thing I want to emphasize, just how much is unknown in this field of study. We know more about the topography of Mars than we do about the sea floor. The ocean takes up to 71% of the Earth's space, yet a whopping 95% of that ocean is completely unexplored. And for good reason. The environmental conditions of these depths are extreme and very hazardous, even lethal. The ocean is amazing, and I know we're all curious to learn more about its depths. And I can tell because one of my earliest videos is blowing up. This video right up here, How Deep Can Whales Dive? Don't click on this link. That sounds like clickbait to in fact click on this link. Please don't. This is one of my very first videos that I published almost 2 years ago to this day in the infancy of this channel. It is a horrible video. I would much rather you watch other videos like my latest charity announcement and the good that we're going to be doing for Oregon Coast Aquarium on July 16th. If you don't know, I'm raising money to build a new wildlife marine rescue center on the Oregon coast.
Well, what do you think about all this?
The fundraiser will be on July 16th over on my Twitch channel, and I hope I'll see you all there. Are we worried about the plane? We're not worried about the plane. We don't care. Can you hear the plane? Let me know in the comments down below. We're trying out our software. It's a test. Can you hear the plane now? It's gotten louder. Is the software erasing it? Let me know. Okay.